The Psychotic Time Wasters present Whose League Is It Anyways? This season starring
The Bones Are His Money and So Are The Worms.
It's PTW Wiz.
He's reaching over your wall, snatching your people up, trying to eat them, so you better hide your kids, hide your wife.
It's PTW Vogue.
Look at her stuff, isn't it neat? Wouldn't you think her collection's complete? It's Daffy Oaks.
Freezinating the countryside, freezinating the peasants.
It's PTW King.
One little prick is all it takes to realize you've made a grave mistake.
It's PTW G-Man.
He wanted me to ask you to check out his seppuku vids on his OnlyFans.
It's PTW King.
He's actually seven dudes in a trench coat. It's Aestus Attorney.
What's up, everyone, and welcome back to Whose League Is It Anyway? Season 6, Match 6. And in this match, we have Aestus Attorney, PTW King, Daffios, and PTW Wizards Lizards going at each other. How is everybody doing tonight?
Pretty good. Doing pretty good.
I'm a little sick, but it's okay.
I'm not sick, but it's okay.
I'm not okay.
Around here. Craig's not okay. But this is also the best Commander League game show on the internet, where everything is made up and the points are the only thing that matters. That's why we're going to get right on to the points. Point Master Vo, what are the Season 6 standings going into Match 6?
Well, we got first place going to Vo with 33 2/3 points, followed up with Daff at 27 2/3 points. Third place, Lizard with 27 1/4 points, followed up by PTW Kink with 24 2/4 points, followed by Aestus with 24, Craig with 23, and Guitar Man coming up the rear.
Well, it did look like everybody had their 7, and while we're waiting on Daff to reconnect, this is a good chance for us to remind you that you, yes, you out there viewing in chat that is now playing in the match right now, can vote at the end of the match to affect the points by the transitive property. You are also the only thing that matters.
The hand has been secured. And now I draw a card. I shall place down upon the field a tranquil thicket and pass my turn.
I'm going to draw Island, Tap, Bathless, Collar, Path.
Forest, ooh. Pass.
Draw. Mikakoro, pass turn.
I shall draw a card. I shall play a plane and pass my turn.
Untap. Draw. Swamp. Do-do-do-do-do-do. Pass.
Draw. Castle Garenbrig enters untapped because I control a forest. Tap 2 for a nature's lore. I'll go get a forest, and I'll pass my turn.
I will draw. I'm going to play Crystal Grotto and Scry 1. I'll tap 2 for a marching duo drone, and I'll pass turn.
I shall draw a card.
When it attacks, everybody makes a treasure token.
I shall play a forest. I will tap 2 and a plains to play a wood elves, which I shall use to secure another forest, and pass my turn.
Draw. We'll play a swamp. We will tap 2 for a blade of the Oni and pass the turn.
Untap and draw. Play an evolving wilds and crack it for a forest. Then I'll pass.
Alright, I will untap. Draw. Hey, I'm going to play a Karn's Bastion for land. And then I'm going to go to combat, swinging 2 at wizards. And everybody makes a treasure token.
Hooray!
Booyah.
I take 2.
First blood.
Is that still a thing?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it definitely is.
Shit.
What do you mean, shit? Yeah, and then while I'm making a treasure token, I will tap 3. For a victory chimes, and I will pass turn.
I will draw a card. I will tap 3 and a plains, and this treasure token, also for a plains, to play Mirare's Wake. No, I played the wrong land. Damn it. Oh, well, it doesn't matter. Pass turn.
Untap. Draw. Play a mountain.
Three. Hey, Craig. Wait, Craig. Real quick. I have a question.
Yes.
If you had an additional mana, could you get rid of a Mirari's Wake?
No.
Okay. You leave my Mirari's Wake alone. It's not bothering you.
Okay. I've seen it. I've noted it. Then no.
It's not bothering you.
Right. Tetsuo is on the field. And I'll pass.
I will give Craig a mana.
You will give me a mana.
A colorless mana.
A colorless mana. I'd love to do something.
I see already that the conspiracy has begun.
I will use it and tap a black and equip this basilisk collar to Tetsuo. Thank you, Death.
You got it.
Pass the turn.
I'm tapping draw. I'll play a forest. Now seems like as good a time as any. I'll play a druid of purification and destroy the Mirari's Wake. Daphne, what do you select?
Daphne, your chimes untaps every untap.
Yes, it does. I'm picking the basilisk collar.
That's a good choice.
Well, then I will show the goodwill that was withheld from me.
I'll pass my turn after that.
I'll play an emergency card. I've top decked two lands so far. Going to tap four for Joyous Familiar. I'm going to go to combat.
I will take
the treasure's worth it.
Yeah, I will pass turn.
I will draw.
I will give Wizard a mana.
Four.
I tell you what, that Victory Chimes thing would probably be really good in that mana burn deck.
You've definitely already gotten all of your help a player points, so you can chill out now.
And then I'll play a Plains. I will use my treasure token and five land to play a Planar Gate.
I'm honestly surprised.
That is a card.
That being said and done, I'll pass my turn. It's a good card.
Untap. Draw. I'm going to play a Choked Estuary tapped. We'll pay four. To put the Blade of the Oni onto Tetsuo. Where do we put it? I will put it over Aestus. Take five. Trigger.
Take five.
Oh, in response, I've got a trigger on the sack.
Yeah, I'm just going to cast the Liberator Urza's Battle Thopter for two mana. That's it.
The trigger, I'll have it do two to death. But they don't trust you right now.
Okay, that's fair.
Pass turn.
I'm going to tap five, and I'm going to play the Mending of Dominaria. Flavor! I'm going to put the top two cards of my library into my graveyard, and I will put a Palaka Worm into my hand. This card just does not go away.
Coming back.
That's your Wanty, huh?
That's my Wanty Malice on this season.
It's just a Palaka all day, every day.
Palaka Worm day. All right, well, with that, that's funny. I'll pass my turn.
On your end step, I'm going to pay one and sacrifice a treasure to cast my commander for two mana.
Do you have flash again?
I have flash from Liberator Urza's Battlethopter. Swinging at you for four. All right, and then I will pass turn.
I will draw a card. I will tap my five here. Reduce the cost by two with my Planar Gate. And have Torsten join the field. The Plains. The Captain of the Watch. A Findhorn Elves. A Breath of Life, which I don't keep. A Plains. A Secluded Step. And a Tristani Discordant.
Okay, that could be a lot scarier.
Yeah, it's not scary. It's just Torsten. What are you afraid of?
Torsten?
Your hand refilling every time you play?
I will play a Plains for turn. And then I will tap a Plains and play a Bastion Protector. He does at the moment, yes. I have 10 cards. I have to discard 3, so I will pass turn and figure that out.
Untap. Play a Mountain. Five. For Torbukui the Younger. He is my left-hand man, so that is flavor points. I will swing at Wizards, but you're not going to be that annoyed because the... Oh, I don't know.
Response to that?
Yeah, I thought so, but he's targeted anyway.
I'm going to pay 2 mana to cast an Ashnod's Altar. And then I will sacrifice Liberator to Ashnod's for 2 mana. I will tap Mikakoro, and this Emergence Zone, Poppy, Lumac, so everybody draws 2 cards, yay!
Everyone else what draws 2 cards.
Okay, continue. You're not getting any more free mana.
I know I'm not, but I'm glad I did it.
Untap and draw. Then we
after
will...
your draw, you get a mana.
Okay, so I'll get a mana in my pool, and I will do the Mending of Dominaria.
I haven't
doing technique. No! Engulfing Slagworm. I'll get this slag right here. I'll play a forest for turn. Seems like a good time for some flavor points, so I'll use that one you gave me. And 6 more. I'll just go ahead and slam the world spell. Woo! But... We're impatient. We read ahead in this house. Skip right to the 3rd one. Pop it in the graveyard. And I'm just going to play this slag right here. And Palaka Worm. You know it. You love it. And I gain 7 life. But I'm going to tap 1 and 3 for this here greater good. Just in case y'all get froggy on me. And I will pass my turn.
Okay, I'll untap. Draw. I'll play this Mishra's Boundary. I somehow will tap for 1. We'll tap for 2 for Cathodion. Sure. I'll pay 1 for a Crashing Drawbridge. Hey, Wiz, do you want a treasure?
Yes.
I smack you for 2.
Yes.
Cool. I'm going to send a 2/2 in the area.
I'm still taking 2, though, right?
Correct. But you get a treasure. Everybody gets a treasure. I will pass turn.
Draw a card. Plains return. I'm going to tap 6 to play True Conviction.
So creatures you control have double strike and
life. And left blank.
Yikes.
Any responses?
I need to be able to defend myself against worms, so I'm going to just sit back and chill. But I'm going to continue my non-aggressive-ass game and pass turn.
Is it my turn, Asus?
So it is your turn.
Go. I play a swamp. We're going to swing Tetsuo at Daphios.
Por qué?
Trigger? Attack trigger? Instant attack trigger. We'll do a ponder. We'll look at the top 3 cards and I may return them or shuffle my library.
I will double block with Cathodion and the drawbridge.
Ooh. What the power toughness of those cards?
Cathodion is a 3/3 and the drawbridge is a 0/4.
Cathodion's power. We'll go to damage.
I'm going to sacrifice Cathodion and the drawbridge.
Cool.
I'll make
a shit fucking ton of mana.
5, 6, 7. And I'll pay 1 to sacrifice Emergence Zone to give my stuff flash. 3. For Traxos, and I'll use the other 3 for Thran Temporal Gateway. So
I'm gonna pay 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Ooh, yeah, for a Tatsuima Dragon's Fang.
Oh, flavorful.
Not. I don't think I called this on flavor points at all, actually, because it's somebody else's sword.
Oh well, it sounds like it's his.
It's not his. I'll pass it down.
Well, on your end step, I'm going to sacrifice Palaka Worm to greater good. I will draw a card off of Palaka Worm dying, and then I will draw 7 cards, and I'll discard 3 forests. Then I'll sacrifice Druid of Purification and I'll draw two cards. And I'll discard one Tragic. Oh. I'll put Crush of Worms in my graveyard. And then I'll sacrifice Engulfing Slagworm and draw seven. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And I'll discard a Forest, Mighty Emergence, and Call Me Ambush.
Oh, and I wonder what's going to happen on your upkeep, or after your draw.
Well, Mending of Dominaria will go off. So I'm going to get all the lands, and everything else will shuffle back, except Mending of Dominaria. I also have no maximum hand size now. Good question. I'm going to play another one for turn. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Sandworm Convergence. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. To make 8 and play Symbiotic Worm. It's a 7/7, and when it goes into the graveyard, I make 7/1/1 green insect tokens. I'll crack my Evolving Wilds. And I'll pass.
On your end step, I'm going to pay 2. I guess I'll have to sack a treasure. And everybody's going to draw 2 cards. Alright, I'll untap and draw. Nice! I'll play this Radiant Fountain I got off the top. I'll play this Goblin Firebomb for free. I'm going to go to combat, swing at Wizard.
With what?
With my Duodrome.
Yeah, I'll take that.
We'll cast a Well of Knowledge. Whoever wants to can pay 2 mana during their draw to draw an additional card. Then I will pass the turn.
I will untap, draw. I'm going to tap 2 to play a Twin Blade Paladin. I need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And one of my treasure tokens makes 6, bring that down to 1, to play Kamal, card of Carissa. I want to enter my combat phase.
Yes. Craig. Alright, I have a response then. I'm going to sacrifice the Duodrone to Ashnod's Altar.
How dare you? He has done so much for all of us.
I'll do 3, 4, and I'll sacrifice Goblin Firebomb to destroy Kamal, Heart of Crosa.
The player doing the least on the board is the one who's being interfered with the most.
I don't know about all that, Aestus.
I don't know about that.
This is the first potentially hostile action I've declared this whole game. Every single time.
Lifelink, trample, and indestructible. Okay.
Yeah, one guy.
Yeah. Presenting Commander Lethal. But
that alters my plan somewhat. The fundamentals of the plan don't change. So I will enter combat fully this time. And I will swing Torsten at the wizard. Torsten is a... He's just a 9/9. With double strike and lifelink and indestructible, but 9.
He's swinging a wizard?
That's very notable.
Pretty notable.
He doesn't have trample.
Oh no. I will declare my symbiotic worm as a blocker.
Okay.
In response to damage, I will sacrifice it to greater good and draw 7 cards and deny the life gain. And I'll discard some ramp cards, I guess. Cultivate, okay. Skyshroud Claim, Rampant Growth.
I see how this is gonna go.
Oh, I also get 7 insects, my bad.
Combat being effectively done, I will pass my turn.
Untap. Draw. Aestus, I'm going to do something very nice to you. And I hope somewhere down the line, you remember this. I'm going to play Creative Technique, and you may demonstrate.
Wiz, I bet you $5 that it's going to be Helm of the Host.
That would be sick.
That would be nice.
Or Blade of Selves.
Ugh.
Yeah, that's even worse.
That would be really good. Not gonna lie. Alright, deck is shuffled.
I hit a Dark Ritual. Aces, you go.
Alright, top card of the deck is Traverse the Outlands.
Could be worse.
Wow, that was an absolute whiff. And Explorer Scope.
Okay, well, Thorsten is a 9, so I guess I'll get 9 lands out of the deck.
You're welcome, Aces.
That's not a terrible outcome, actually. I'll take that.
I don't understand.
I will take that. One.
Two. We'll use the 3 black from the Dark Ritual to equip the Dragon Fang to Tetsuo. And we will also pay 1 and equip the Explorer Scope to Tetsuo. I will play the Swamp, the land for turn. We'll pay 1 blue. And we will give Tetsuo Shadow until end of turn and draw a card. We will go to combat. Dachius, you have a 10 menace shadow coming at you.
I'll take 10 because I can't block it.
No. Attack triggers. Oh, Aces, I know I helped you, but I've really got to take that Instructable for your commander.
I'm okay with that, actually.
Yeah, I will ping that Indestructible with your commander. I'm going to reveal the top card. Well, I'm not going to reveal it. I'm going to look at it and put it back as I ain't a land. And then Daphias take 10, and I will pass the turn.
I'm going to tap 4. Y'all are going to roll your eyes, but Druid of Purification, it's back. And I'm going to target True Conviction.
Of course you fucking are.
It's scary, Aestus.
I've done nothing with it!
Daphias, what are you going to target?
What equipments have you got, Craig?
I have an Explorer Scope, a Blade of the Oni, and a Tatsumasa Dragon's Fang.
I pick Tatsumasa.
Okay, what is this, this gateway of which you spoke? What does it do?
I can pay 4 mana to put a historic permanent from my hand onto the battlefield.
Yeah, let's get rid of that one.
Cool. And I will target the Ashnod's Altar.
I'm going to tap 4 and cast a Maskwood Nexus and turn everything into worms.
Oh my god. Do you have enough to cast Baru? No.
Probably time for Baru. I'll go to combat and I'll just get swinging. Let's do it. At Daff. 4 insects at Craig, 3 insects at Aces.
How much damage? You.
They're all 3/3s with trample. So if you have 4 of them coming at you, you're looking at 12.
I will declare Tobukui the Younger as a blocker for 1 of them.
Okay.
I'll declare no blockers. If he has some shenanigans, I guess I'll buy.
Cool. I will pay 2 for an Umezama's Charm, giving Tobukui +2/+2.
So that he won't die? Okay.
So that he won't die, and when I cast an instant or sorcery spell, which I probably should have done for the other ones, I will do 2 damage to your face wizard, and because it's Tobukui, I'll gain 2. You attack me with 3, you'll do 9, and I'll gain 5. So I'll take 4.
And Aces?
I will block one of the 3/3 worms with my 3/3 double strike. And I guess I'll reduce the other damage by 1 with the Woodland Elves, which leaves me with 5.
Sounds good.
That is not bad.
That was a good turn. I liked it.
That was a good turn.
Is there anything else?
Nope, that's it. That's turn.
We'll untap. Draw. Yeah, sure. I'll use Victory Chimes and the Grotto to draw an extra card. I will pay 3 for a Treasure Keeper. Alright, I'll pass turn.
Okay, untap phase. Is the thing that lets me... It does. I'll tap 2 and draw an extra card on my draw phase. 1, 2.
You can pay that as many times as you want, by the way.
I will need my strength for what is to come. I'll play a Plains Return. I'll tap 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I will use it to play Cleansing Nova to destroy all creatures on the board. This paladin will die. Torsten will return to the...
Are there any responses, wizard?
To what?
Cleansing Nova, destroy all creatures.
Seems cool.
I have a response. I'm going to withdraw. I'm going to target my Tobukui and Tetsuo, and the Tobukui trigger, I'll fire Aestus for 2 damage, and I'll gain 2.
They're just going to kill everything.
Everything is dead.
Okay.
With the exception of my 7 dudes.
Three or
because
less.
I withdrew, Blade the Oni will be a creature and it will also eat shit.
Okay. Gerard's Hourglass Pendant.
Full Torsten back onto the board. Up seven cards. Here we go. We need something to make some stuff work. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. A Pearl Medallion that I can't use. Reveille Squad. That's nice. A Forest. A Marshall's Anthem. A Forest. A Plains. And a Cultivate. Great. Land.
Lands.
3. She play Danitha, Benalia's Hope. When she comes into play, she will pull my Blackblade Reforged out of my hand and equip it to herself, which is going to give her +17, +17, which puts her at a 21-21 first strike vigilance lifelink. I will leave the one planes open. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I need to get rid of 2. I will discard a planes and a forest. And I'll pass turn.
Untap. Sorry, I already untapped. Draw. Blaze Mountain. 2, 3. From Tetsuo.
Yeah, I'm giving you a mana.
You're going to give me a mana. Tetsuo has no colorless in his cost. But I will use that colorless for the Exploroscope. I will pay 1 red for a rabbit battery. I will pay 1 red to reconfigure the rabbit battery. He's a 4-4. How big is Torsten?
He's a 7-7.
He's a big boy, right?
Big-ish.
We're swinging a wizard. Tetsuo trigger, I'll ping one of those soldiers, and they'll be dead.
Okay, in response to the target, I'm going to tap 3 and tap my Maskwood Nexus to make a changeling and declare that as a blocker.
You may do you, boo. How big's the changeling? It's a 2-2.
2-2.
I'll pass the turn.
You cast a summon spell this turn. I'll tap 4, and I'll cast Lure of Prey.
Summon spell.
I smell fucking prey. Plated slagworm. This slag right here. This can't be the target of spells or abilities your opponents control, so don't even think about it. Untap. Play land. I'll tap 3. I'll play Rites of Flourishing. Do a heck and think. Tap 5 for a Bellowing Tangleworm. It's a 4-4 with Intimidate, and other green creatures I control have Intimidate. I will tap my Castle Garen Brig along with 4 others to make 6. And cast Baru, Worm Speaker. I'll hit Craig for 10. I'll play a Forest as my second land for turn. Interesting, interesting. I'm going to tap 4 and cast Healing Technique. I'll allow Craig to demonstrate. We'll target the Mending of Dominaria.
I will target Creative Technique.
I will then get Druid of Purification back.
Then I'll do 5, game 5.
So that's 9. Go to 43.
Maybe I'll get a best shot next time I do it.
And I'll pass my turn.
I will untap. Draw 2. 6. For a Scavenged Brawler. Got Flying, Vigilance, Trample, Lifelink. I will pass turn.
Untap. I'll tap 2. And 2 more. Draw 4 cards. I'm going to play a Forest and a Plains for turn. I'll tap a Plains. Play a Stalwart Pathfinder. So I'll tap a Plains. Play a Cathar Commando. I'll then tap another Plains to sacrifice it and use it to destroy your sacrifice on command enchantment.
Actually, in response, I'll sack my 10-10 and draw 10 cards.
Tap 1, 2, 3, 4. To play Captain of the Watch. He will make 3 dudes to play King Darien of the Super Bowl, and then I will announce my entrance into the combat phase.
Before you go into combat, what I'm going to tap 2, going to ram through the one that's beefing up all your little dudes. So I'll deal 7 damage to it, and any XX damage will be done to your face.
Alright, so that's 4, I take 3.
Yep.
I will then enter my combat phase.
Go off, Queen.
You can't attack, and you can't attack. But Danitha can attack, and she does. Torsten can attack, and he does. And these 6 dudes can attack, and they do. So the 6 dudes are 2/2s. Torsten is a 8/8. Danitha is a 24/24 with first strike, vigilance, and lifelink.
It's all coming at me?
It's all coming at you.
I'm going to block Danitha with a worm.
All right.
Take the rest.
All right, so that's 8 from Torsten and 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12 from the soldiers.
So I'll take 20.
And I will gain, what did I say, 24? So I will gain 24. All right, I'm in considerably better shape now than I have been before. During main phase 2, I'm going to go ahead and tap 3 to play a harvest season and search my deck for 6, 7 lands and put them into play. That's a non-basic. That's a non-basic.
Oh no.
I think I've got 6 basic lands left in my deck. yeah, that's all of them. So I didn't get the full 7, but I do get 6. I will tap 2 to play a Reveille squad. And 1 more to play Danitha, the Capuchin Paragon. That all being said and done, I will pass my turn.
Beautiful. Untap. I'll draw just the once. Oh no, I'll draw twice.
You're giving me a mana.
Okay. I'm going to play an island. 4. I'm going to leave that floating. I'm going to pay 1 first. I'm going to play a Mystic Mora. Then I'm going to Creative Technique with you, Daphius. Whoop. Island. Purple Master Wizard. Nice. And you go, Daphius?
Grand Dynamo. I will take it.
And then I'll get Kedis, Emberclaw Familiar. Wizard, what's the stat line of the creatures you got out?
I got a 6/6 and a 5/5.
Get protected up. Only a second main. I'm going to play a Tetsuko Umezawa Fugitive. Another story card. Because he's family. And I'll move to my end step. End step trigger, Hurkle. I've cast an enchantment and a sorcery. This turn, that are non-creature spells. I'll reveal the top 5 cards from the library for each card type among them. Yeah. If I get an enchantment and a sorcery, I may put them in my hand. There's a sorcery, show and tell. I'll put the show and tell in my hand. The rest of the box. Ugh. Alright. Pass turn.
On your end step, Aces, how many untapped green creatures do you have?
One.
How big is it?
Darien is a 2/3.
Untap. Alright. I'm gonna tap 5 lands and Castle Garenbrig to produce 7 mana and play Bramble Worm. Gain 5 life. 5. An attempt to cast Overwhelming Stampede.
You gonna pay 4 for that one?
Nope, you're good.
Cool. I'll draw. What the XX on Overwhelming Stampede?
Right now it's 9/9.
Continue.
Yeah, just thinking. I'm gonna tap 3 for a Balaged Recovery. I'm going to put Overwhelming Stampede back in my hand. You can draw.
Thank you.
In fact, you know what? Draw again, because I'm going to cast Overwhelming Stampede again.
Yep, I'm drawing.
I'm going to give all my creatures plus 18, plus 18. This has 18, 9, 27, plus 5, so my commander is 32.
Cool. And the fattest one is a 36, 36, right? That's how Overwhelming Stampede works.
One is 9, 18, 36. Yep. I'll declare Baru attacking Craig, and I'll declare Brambleworm. Oh, Brambleworm can't attack, so I'll declare Bellowing Tangleworm at Daphios.
I'll announce my brawler as a blocker.
Cool. I'm going to tap. Or I'm going to Aetherize.
Well, had to try.
Oh.
Yeah. I've been holding that was in my starting hand. I've been holding that up all game.
A valiant attempt, I will say.
Pass turn.
I'll draw two. I'm not going to pay additional. Play Shrine of the Forsaken Gods. All right, I'll sacrifice this treasure and three.
I still have that treasure over there.
Four or five, I mean. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yes. 5 for Forsaken Monument. Sure. 2, 3, 4, 5, and cast my commander. Just gonna pass turn and hope I'm not dead.
Alright, untap. Untap of planes. Play an Intrepid Hero. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. To play Cathar's Crusade. Then I will tap 1. Play an Angel of Vitality. Play a Planets of Heroes. I announce that I will enter into the combat phase. I will attack Wizard with my 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 3-3s. I will attack Daphios with a Torsten and a Danitha.
I would like to pay Victory Chimes to activate Mistress Foundry. Declare it as a blocker for Torsten and the brawler as a blocker for Danitha.
I'll declare no blockers.
I did the math wrong!
Well, don't really care what your math was, because I'm going to cast Moment's Peace and fog you.
Well, fine then. Alright, well, that being said and done, I will pass my turn.
Untap. Draw. Cool. Very cool. Play an island. Play a swamp. Tap 3. For a show and tell. Each player may put an artifact, creature, or enchantment, or land card from their hand onto the battlefield.
An enchantment, you say?
Enchantment, creature, artifact, or land.
Cool.
I will put into play...
Ooh, spicy, Daff.
Elbrus, the Binding Blade. What does Daff put into play?
Fraying Line.
Oh, fuck and, you.
Wizard, would you... Shut up, Craig. You see what we got next to us? Wizard,
I'm thinking you, the you world can't pay spell.
That. You can't pay that, right? You can't pay Fraying Line's trigger.
Me?
On your turn?
No, it's too expensive. It's too expensive for me.
Okay.
Yeah, this is untapped.
Exiles creatures, correct?
Yes.
On my
which is creatures. What we want right now.
Right?
I was trying to figure out how to get Fraying Line to work, but this is great.
I guess I'll put that in exploration.
I'll do the world spell and I have triggers.
You do your triggers.
I'm going to put in, knowing what I know right now, I'll choose Druid class. I'll do a Sakura Tribe Elder. Damn, shitty world spell.
I will. Will you block with Steve if I attack you? Steve dies, you get the trigger, right, Wizard?
Yep.
Cool. I'm going to pay 1. Put the Elbrus onto Tetsuo. And I will swing at you, Wizard.
I'll block with Steve.
Cool. Attack trigger. Sorry. Attack trigger first. I'm going to Lacrimas Creativity. Target myself. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Draw 6 cards. And then discard.
That's what you meant. Gotcha.
And then I'll discard Enthusiastic Mechanaut. I want to flip the
block Paradise. With Steve. Sack it before damage.
Yeah. Torbaku with the Younger. That's 3. Wheel of Fate in there.
Oh my god.
Solar Stone. This island. Yeah, I guess that's it. Pass the turn.
Is it on upkeep? Untap?
Yes, it is.
Upkeep, everything is exiled.
Okay, so you're not paying it.
I am not paying it, so all creatures will be exiled.
Yes, in response to, I guess, my own trigger.
I forgot my own Herkul trigger with her. Sorry. I only hit a sorcery.
We'll copy Mikikoro's effect. We'll all draw two cards. Oh, Fraying Line. That's show and tell, Craig.
Yeah, I know.
Alright, I'll draw for turn.
Rabbit Battery comes in to play as a creature. Because it was not a creature at start.
You have a Maya Cradle of Growth.
No, where is...
And... A Hideaway Land. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Also,
I'll tap 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Cast the Mending of Dominaria. Mill 2. Bookworm. And Colony Ambush. I will put, I guess, Symbiotic Worm back in my hand. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. I'll play Worldspine Worm. Let's tap 1, 2, 3, 4 for Druid of Purification. Yeah.
Cool.
I cast the Mending of Dominaria.
Okay, cool. I'm going to draw one for that.
Druid of Purification. I will select the big-ass sword that Aestus has.
I'll choose the fish, Craig.
Not Elbrus?
Hold on. Craig, if you don't pick my monument, I won't pick your Elbrus.
Yeah, you have a deal.
I don't have anything to select.
Okay.
Bro. Absolute bro. I will also choose to not pick.
Wow, look at you all go. Pass turn. Make a worm.
I will untap. Draw two. I'll tap this for 4, 5, 6, 2, 2, 3, 4 for a smelting vat. Play a powder keg. And I'm going to pay one. Sacrifice the Well of Knowledge to smelting vat. Mech Titan Core is the only thing. 2, 3. Transmogrifying Wand. I will pass turn.
Draw. At one, we have Soul Warden. At two, we play a Pearl Medallion. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 mana. Play Torsten again. Get a hit point. Top 7 cards. Let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We've got Austere Command, the Night Captain of Eos, Cultivate, Ray of Dawnbringer, Myral Shield of Argrive, I Call the Coppercoats, and a Heron Blade Elite. Alright, well that's something to work with. He's going back down to the bottom. Well, it's 3, so I tap 1, 2, 3, 4. Play a Ray of Dawnbringer, tap a green to play a Heronblade Elite, tap a Plains to play Mirel, and tap 2 to play the Knight Captain of Eos. And he comes into the field, put 2/1/1 white soldier creature tokens into play. So I now have two dudes.
All right. Well, Craig, something needs to happen about that.
It doesn't seem to matter how much rude shit you do on this table. You managed to convince everybody else I'm the one that needs to be dealt with. What?
Your politicking has no power here. We can see your board state.
My board state is moderate at best.
I'm getting an update from Daphios that their power just went out.
Alright, what was the order in which Rhea first, then you, then you, then you... than two soldiers. I still have Cathar's Crusade. So, and then I gain 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 hit points, taking me up to 50. Tap 2 to play Defiler of Faith. None of these things have haste, so I will pass my turn.
On your end step, Craig, you got a way to deal with that Knight Captain.
I do, but you ain't gonna like it.
Yeah, whatever. Bring it.
I think if it sounds reasonable, we'll play as if Daff is here at 32 life and no blocks. So if you want to win, you need to kill Daff.
That seems fair. Do you have any responses on Aces's end step?
I do, but if you want, if you'd rather respond with your way, my way is not very pleasant for the table.
All right, I'll tap three and I'll beast within your knight, Captain of Eos. Infinite Fogs does not fly well with me.
Well, fine then. I'll tap a Plains and sacrifice the Knight Captain of Eos to immunize myself against combat for this turn.
You got it.
Draw. Pay 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 for my commander. Second time from the command zone. We'll pay 1. Put a rabbit battery on him. We'll pay 1 to put the Elbrus Binding Blade on him. We'll play this island and a Smoldering Marsh. And gonna pay 5 for Ancestral Memories. 1, 2, 3, 4. Running Powered Auto Generator comes in tap. I'll pass the turn.
Untap. Place. Mending of Dominaria. Vigor Spore Worm and a Momentous Fall. I'll grab the Vigor Spore Worm. 1, 2, 3, 4 for Baru. I'll tap 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 for Vigor Spore Worm. Targeting World Spine Worm. It's going to give it plus X, which I believe is 1, 2. I'll give it +6/+6 and Vigilance until end of turn. Or 6 with my Castle Garenbrig. To cast Kamal, Heart of Krosa. Flavor win. And then I'll tap 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 for Predatory Rampage. Creatures you control get +3/+3 until end of turn, and each creature your opponents control blocks this turn if able. World Spine Worm is going at Aestus, and the other worm is going at Craig.
Oh, how big is the worm?
21. Oh, no, the one coming at you, sorry, is 10-10.
10-10.
Trample.
Well, when you attack me with that World Spine Worm.
Yeah.
I'm going to tap me a Plains. I'm going to play a Swords to Plowshares to exile it.
That's a good choice.
It's a very good choice. I wish I had the same choice. But I do not, so Tetsuo is going to eat shit and die.
The World Spine Worm was a 27-27, so it will be exiled, and I will gain 27 life.
Fucking hell.
Hey, I was trying to bring this game closer to an end. You're the one who chose to give me all that life.
Just volunteer to die.
I will tap two to cast the spell that's under here, Traverse the Outlands. I'm going to go get basically all the lands that are in my graveyard. Or in my deck, I can get 10 basics and put them into play tap, and I'll pass.
Alright, draw and draw again.
I'll find 8 and fail to find.
Use Rhea Dawnbringer to return the Knight Captain of Eos to the board. I'll play a Command Tower for turn. I'm going to use a Plains. I'm going to sacrifice Torsten to make 7 dudes. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12... To put Torsten back on the board again, which is going to trigger the shit. I'll get to that in a minute. I'm going to pull the top 7 cards. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We've got Sigil of Mudon, Breath of Life, Fog, Saga Tribe Elder, Benelish Marshal, Essence Warden, and Champion of the Parish. That for a white and a green. The white will play the champion. Actually, the white will play the Essence Warden. And the white will play for the Champion of the Parish. Tap 3 to play a Benelish Marshal. Oh, I got a new Benalia. Play that for turn because why not at this point? 2 white. Play an Aerial Responder and everything else is just going to get 1 more. I gained from that 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 hit points. I could do that again, but I really don't want to. Yes. Wizard, what do you have on your side of the board to defend yourself with?
5 blockers.
5 blockers. All right.
And you can't attack me in the air.
3, 4.
You just win this with damage here. You can kill both Craig and I.
I'm pretty sure.
I don't, like, and not everything that I have has...
Well, I thought all your soldiers could attack this turn.
No, they can't. A lot of them came into play this turn.
Gotcha. Well, you're presenting a very scary board, then. I don't think I'm going to die this turn, though.
No, I can't kill you because you have too many defenders. I could do damage to you, but I can't kill you outright.
Yeah, but you could kill Daphios.
I could kill Daphios.
You do get 2 points for killing Daphios, if I remember.
How many hit points does she have?
32.
32? So Soul Warden and a dude will swing at Daphios for 2. Well, for 32. Exactly.
Beautiful.
Fatality.
We no longer have to worry about that problem.
Greg, you are going to get the Rhea Dawnbringer for 5. 26 in the air from Rhea Dawnbringer, unless you can stop it.
I cannot stop it. I will die.
All right. Then I will pass turn to the wizard.
Untap. Draw. And then I will have a trigger on Mending of Dominaria. Do I have any lands in my graveyard? Don't believe I do. Probably just the one. How many green creatures you got, Asus?
1, 2, 3. 3.
Okay. I can work with that. Let's tap 5. Go ahead and cast that Bellowing Tangleworm. Let's tap 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And cast a Elderscale Worm.
Okay.
So my life total cannot go below 7. Then let's go ahead and cast 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's save that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8. It's actually 8 for a Symbiotic Worm. Let's tap 5. And cast Overwhelming Encounter. I'll roll a d20. It's an 18, so I'll put 2 1-1 counters on each creature I control. And I will go to combat.
Cool. I'm going to save you the trouble of tapping any of that shit.
Well, it all is vigilance, so I won't have to, but go on.
And I'm just going to pay a white attack a dude and neutralize combat damage for the turn.
All right, you still have that dickhead. All right, cool, pass.
Cool. Draw a card, draw another card. Rhea Dawnbringer will bring back a Stalwart Pathlighter with a type of planes and kill Torsten. It costs 17 mana to put him on the board.
Nice. Hey, at least you secured those points.
It's reduced by 2 by Planar Gate and 1 more by Pearl Medallion. But it's still expensive as shit. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We're gonna get Rampant Growth that's come to my hand. Brought back doesn't. That does. Sunscorched Regent does. Helm of the Host goes away. Blade of Selves goes away. And my Regret Dawnbringer comes in. Now tap this Harrenblade Elite for all the mana. And play an Hour of Reckoning to destroy all non-token creatures on the board.
Yeah, no responses. Or sorry, 7 and 6.
Fuck, he makes tokens. Alright, Torsten died again. So 14 dudes have come onto the board in total.
Oh, sorry. Before you destroy all creatures, can I activate Baru?
I will attack with... Yeah, before I play a Sacred Tribe Elder, plus 1 more. Yeah, before I play a Land of War Elves, plus 1 more. Tap a forest, play a Farhaven Elf, plus 1 more. Tap 2 more to play a Sunscorched Regent, that's plus 1 more. 3 to play Darien, King of Keldor, for 1 more. And I don't have enough planes open to play the last one. So everything gets plus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, plus 5. Alright, We're gonna swing with these. All right, I'll swing with these seven dudes.
I'll declare my seven insects as blockers, and in response, before damage, I'm gonna tap seven and cast Kindred Summons. I'll get 11 creatures from my library. Got a couple of ETB triggers there. Let's show everybody what we got. Heartwood Storyteller, Croson Drover, Sakura Tribe Elder, Thunderfoot Bailoff, Engulfing Slagworm, Silverback Elder, Avatar of Growth, Defiler of Vigor. That's a cast. God damn it. Sifter Worm, Veteran Explorer, and Plated Slagworm. So you can search your library for two lands and put them into play. And I will scry three. Put them back like this.
No more lands exist.
I will reveal the top card, which is the world spell, and I will gain seven life.
And that's all that I'm going to be able to pull out for this turn, so I'll pass.
And tap and draw. Draw again, because I draw two. I will tap 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I will cast Natural Reclamation, and I will target Cathar's Crusade and Cascade into Balaged Recovery. Balaged Recovery will target Elder Scale Worm. That'll go back to my hand. Let's tap. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 4. The World Spell. Skip to the end for Elder Scale Worm. And Panglacial Worm. How many artifacts or enchantments do you have, my friend?
3.
3? What are they?
Pearl Medallion, Planar Gate, and Exploration.
Cool. I'm going to tap 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and cast my commander. Ugh, there's one card in my deck I need so bad. Yeah, I guess I'll tap 3 to upgrade Druid class, and then I'll tap 5 to do it again and turn my Evolving Wilds into a big fucker. And I've only cast one creature, so all of these things except the Evolving Wilds will get a +1 counter from my Defiler of Vigor. And then I'm going to go to combat and give you the full swing.
So what am I looking at here?
Well, everything on my board has +5 from the counter, except this guy, but from the counter, Thunderfoot Bailoff, and Baru. So just off of that, let's do 5, 10, 15... 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 55, 60, 65, 70, 75, 79, without counting the creature's actual power and toughness.
Okay.
So lethal if you don't block. How big are your soldier tokens?
Seven of them are... these 14 over here are... Seven of them are 7/7s. There's a 7, a 6, a 5, a 4, a 3, a 2, and a 1. What? And then there's the veteran token.
Yep. I'm going to go ahead and say that I cannot win at this point.
Okay.
There's one card I needed to draw this turn, and I did not get it.
Like, the one thing I was worried about is whether or not, like, if they have Intimidate, then I can't really do anything about it.
No, they don't. That card's gone right now.
Okay, I thought you
actually might have... Wait, no, I still have Elder Scale Worm, so unless you have removal, I'm good.
Yep, I think that's going to do it.
You're just going to take it?
I cannot mitigate enough of it without my soldiers.
Fair enough.
If my soldiers could block them, I could survive this.
Good game. What a slog.
Fucking hell.
It's honestly hard to know, like, who played more flavorful cards because we both played our entire deck.
Pretty much, yeah.
I finally got into a loop where I could replay my deck as many times as I wanted. What I was looking for at the end, which I did not get, which would have been glorious, is Predatory Rampage, which makes all of your creatures block if able on Engulfing Slagworm. All creatures that block it are destroyed, and I gain life equal to their toughness. But good game. Jeepers.
Yeah, man.
That was a
hell of a fight.
Indeed. Good game all around.
I'm
point Master Vo.
Are you with us?
Point Master, wake up!
He has died of old age.
Ah, shit.
That's right. I'm thousands of years old, and I'm dead.
Do we have notable scorings for the match?
Who cast their commander the most?
Definitely, definitely Aestus. No question.
No, we'll get on to the voting.
I didn't realize that my deck could do it until I was looking at it.
Starting with Aestus for the best theme.
Best theme? I'm probably going to have to go with the 2 point for Baru the Worm Speaker, because good God, that was a lot of worms. The secondary point I will give to... I think I'll give to Dathios. There's a lot of artifact stuff going on, and I'm pretty sure more would have happened if we hadn't lost her to the power borking. God rest her angry soul.
Great.
Theme. Torsten deck. Jesus Christ. You want to defend the wall? That guy defended the fucking wall. Alright, and 1 point to the worms.
I'm going to give my 2 theme points to Dathios. Especially those first couple of turns. That was pretty nuts, though. And then, yeah, I got to give one to Aestus. I mean, you played your entire deck, so you had to hit your flavorful cards.
I'd certainly hope so by that point.
Do we have Dathios's voting?
Yep, voting for the worms and Benalia. And looks like Chad's also voting for the worms are their money. Which take us to the splash cheese play.
I'm going to say... I mean, it's ultimately going to go to Wizard. The comeback from that last board wipe was nuts. The 1 point I will give to... I'll give to Craig. So, 2 to Wizard, 1 to Craig.
Flashy ass play. I want to give 2 to Wizard for looping that overrun.
Yeah, that was fun.
That was fun. If you hadn't attacked me, I would have let it through. I'm not gonna lie. There's a couple of loops. I'll give 1 to Aestus for looping the... Looping the commander into Cathar's Crusade. That was pretty fucking splashy.
So gross.
It's very gross.
For splashiest play, I gotta give Aestus 2 points for that Swords to Plowshares. Holy shit. I thought I had it. I thought I was gonna get... Like, I thought I was gonna win with commander damage a couple times. It was just... Ugh. Tragic. Tragedy. And then 1 point for splashiest play will go to the fraying line off of Show and Tell. So I'm going to give that point to Daff. I liked that.
Daff is voting for the Aetherize.
Oh, yeah, that was good, too.
Aetherize was good, too.
Wizard's Fog. Chat's also voting for the Aetherize. That'll go to the Wanty Malison category.
Wanty Malison. Well, fucking that damn purification druid. Jesus Christ.
Yeah, you did not like that this game.
I needed that purification druid. I saw him on that board no less than 4 times. Jeez, that was irritating.
In there for Daff, not even you.
Yeah, I think I'm going to go with the 2 points because I've been reminded that it did happen. I got to give 2 points for that Aetherize because that was a pretty clutch card. I'll give the 1 point to the Eternal Goram Purification Druid.
Yeah, I got to get the Purification Druid, just too much work. I can get the 2 points for sure. I'm stuck between the Fraying Line and the Knight Captain for the 1 point, and I may give it to the Fraying Line, actually. Yeah, I'll give the 1 point to Daff for the Fraying Line.
I'm going to give 2 points to New Shimmermere. Like, what the hell? That card's really good. That's the first time I had ever seen that.
Hopefully it's the last time.
Yeah, right? Also, Urza's Battlethopter, like, that's great flavor points, too. Just tossing that in there. And then the one backup point is going to be a tie between... Nah, fuck it. It's just going to be Planar Gate. That was in play for so long. It was so stupid. Everyone was like, yeah, no, it's fine. Aces can just play a discounted game.
I never expected that to last the entire game. Good lord.
Nuts, dude.
I didn't even know it was in play. I'm not gonna lie.
Death votes for greater good and the gate.
Yeah, the greater good and the ending of Dominaria felt really good.
Yeah, fuck me. There were just so many good cards doing so much work.
Chat is also voting for the greater good. Looks to be everything. No whoopie doo magic 30s today.
Oh, fuck, I forgot! I hate this rule.
Just leaving points on the table. That's why I'm winning. I've called it every time, man. That's why I'm winning. Anyway, that's going to wrap up the voting. And we're going to have some results here. Okay. With 21 points, we're going to have a tie for third with Craig and Daff. With 28 points, we got second place going to Astis, which means the worms are his money, and so are the bones. 35 points to Wizard.
35? Good lord.
Yeah, well, what can I say? Y'all gave him a bunch of voting points. Putting them in to the totals. For the seasonal standings, first place not changing, but second place, we got Wizard moving up to 28.8 points. Daff falling down a little bit, but still at third with 26. Astis right behind, fourth place with 25, followed up by Kink with 24.75 points. Craig with 22.75, and coming up the rear, it's Guitar Man.
Can we get him a t-shirt that just says coming up the rear is Guitar Man?
Like this video and subscribe to the PTW YouTube channel to see more content and find out when our new videos release.
Follow the PTW Twitch channel and subscribe for ad-free viewing.
Don't forget to follow that Facebook and that Twitter to keep up with all the good news.
Thank you all for watching.
Are you happy about it?